If you're okay to just take one more question from Lizzie and then we can wrap up. Lizzie?
Yes, hi, good evening, everyone. Just going off the back of Claire's question, I read today that only 55% of 18-year-olds are currently enrolled to vote. Yeah. So I wanted to get an idea about how we're going to look at the disillusionment, I guess, externally as well as internally, coming off the back of some of those tragic stories that we've heard from federal government lately with bullying and some issues inside around that. So how can we look internally to fix that?
Thanks very much for your question, Lizzie. Another stat that I've seen around, I don't know if you've seen it or not, that's of great concern, is the diminishing support for democracy as our form of government. That's a real concern that people out there don't get why democracy is important. And that's why forums like this and our federal campaigns are so critical that people get to participate in. In some countries, of course, people risk their lives to fight for the right to vote. We have such a proud history in this country in terms of women's participation in the political system is one thing that we were the first country in the world where that occurred. But we need to do much better. We need to engage, I think, with young people. We need to engage on issues that involve them because they are our future. And I know that young people are particularly concerned about issues like climate change, making sure that the world that they inherit is one that's at least as pristine as the one that's there at the moment. So I think it's a matter of us reaching out, engaging, working out new ways of participation as well in the political process, because I think that figure of 55%, I think you said, of 18-year-olds enrolled is of real concern, and we need to look at ways as well of making it easier for people to get on.